thought we'd done some tall fighting, and were believed to be in the reserve line. But it was soon found that the reserves were all dispatched, and the front line was gone. So seen in the distance ahead of us were brigades of Rebs coming fast. Later, it was found out to be Reb General Bushrod Johnson's, General A.P. Stewart's, and a division from the Army of Northern Virginia. We were in part supposed to stop their progress, like a clapboard stopping a tornado.
Some of the men saw Irish General Claiborne roll forward his men. He was considered like our General Forrest, and when he went into action late in the day, he further convinced the Yankees they may want to find a safer place. General Claiborne's men did some tall fighting. The darkness came upon the field, and both sides seemed whipped.
Oh!
The fighting had raged from Jay's Mill to the Vineyard Farm, back and forth over the Lafayette Road and almost upon Old Rosie's headquarters. Our army buckled hard a few times, but held up to the test. Much of the army was in the vicinity or within supporting distance. The fighting may be in earnest if we stay in the morning. I am not sure either side considered who won the day, but as we were allowed to wrap our blankets around us on a cold, uncomfortable night, many would consider this a last sleep.
Seems sad that so many men could die to amount to nothing but a few yards of battlefield. But the good Lord knows his well-made plans. We could only guess the Lord's plans for the next of the cock's crow. But what plans for you, General Bragg?